Oh, there we are.
Right, okay. So why were you working for Alan Sugar?
I wasn't directly working for him. I was working for a catering company when I first left drama school, like a lot of good drama students, black trousers, white shirt, handing around the drinks and the canapes. And I turned too quickly and knocked three glasses of red wine, I remember everything, two glasses of white wine and four canapes down a lady's top.
And the lady was?
Angry.
Cross. I had no idea who he was until years later when I saw him on the telly and I thought, that's the... two fired me.
So he was he standing next to...
Yes, yes, it was his do. He was the host of the do and I was summarily dispensed with.
Dispensed of or disposed with.
Dispersed.
Yeah.
Tossed off.
Thank you.
What's the name of the catering company?
Oh, God, Mayflower. Well done.
you were the one that remembered it.
Yes, I know.
It's good that he can pat him there on the back of it.
Yeah.
Well done.
It was
Martin
a long time
Clunes.
Ago.
Well done. Yes. This is where I live. Well done.
So what? So she was cross... And he was
she
standing
was,
next
honest,
to her.
To be honest, she was just wet and dirty, as I remember. But he was. No, yes. She was just busy with dealing, you know, worrying about her clothes. And his summary firing of me was a sort of display for her benefit. As much
so
as anything.
So he was right there and he did
he
it
was, yes,
himself?
Yes, 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 yes.
Did he use his catchphrase?
He's a lovely man.
You fart. Did he do that?
Yeah. Of Rocky Balboa, yeah. I think.
You fart. Yeah, you fart. You fart, Edwin. You fart.
Please, that's a very good Rocky Balboa, but doesn't he really sound a bit more like this? I look very good. I look very
What did he actually say to
Oh,
him?
God, I can't remember. There was anger, there was shouting. He didn't swear, but he made me look stupid. But cunningly, I already look stupid. So well, I thought that didn't really hurt.
Right, David.
Quickly, I'll tell you.
Mayflower came so swiftly, it was brilliant.
I think Mayflower sounds very much like a sort of outside catering company.
But do you think that if you're the guest who's been spilt all over, wet and dirty, that... he would have turned round and said, you're fired.
It's a very nasty thing to do, because it's only an accident.
And you were 20.
You were full of apologies at this
moment. Of course I was full of apologies. I had some spillage on me, but I didn't, you know, bang on
didn't
about
blame
that.
Her. That was probably a wise course not to go, what are you doing, you stupid bitch? Standing right in my way!
He's telling the truth.
You think he is telling the truth?
I think he is telling the truth.
It,
but
think?
He's that's... a brilliant actor.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well,
you
he's
are.
An actor.
I mean, with the greatest respect, we're not talking about Robert De Niro, are we? It's Martin Clunes. I mean...
Is he going to do Robert De Niro now?
I can't do him.
Go on, have a stab.
Have I got Pacino for you?
No, I said Robert De Niro.
Robert De Niro.
Come on, cocky.
That's all I can do.
That was a monkey. Robert De Niro as a monkey. He's very versatile. He could do a monkey that well.
What's that? Al Pacino. Okay.
Tom Jones. Robert De Niro, that isn't it? With longer arms.
No, Al Pacino. Al Pacino is. Okay, Pacino. Okay. What do you got?
That's Columbo.
It is a very good Ronnie Corbett.
Yeah.
So who's guessing? Who's if that ends up in the show? I'm gone. Come on, everybody. Let's have a guess.
Well, I think you instinctively think it's true.
I'm going to go with true.
Well, I haven't got a clue.
So. I can only go with firm.
Well,
can
I
you?
Think yes. Let's go
Lovely.
With you.
Okay,
right.
We're going with Fern, and you're saying that it's true. Martin Clunes, our greatest living actor. Yes. Were you telling the truth or were you telling a lie?
I was telling a porky pie.
Oh,
no!
Yes, Martin was telling a lie, and why should we be surprised? He is a wonderful actor. So, at the end of that round, David's team have just 1 point. Lee's in the lead with 3. Our next round is called This Is My, where we bring on a mystery guest who has a close connection to one of our panellists. This week, each of David's team will claim it's them that has the genuine connection to the guest, and it's up to Lee's team to spot who's telling the truth. So please welcome this week's special guest, Ken. Welcome, Ken. So, Richard, first of all, what is Ken to you?
This is Ken. He produced my record, a dance version of a Shakespearean soliloquy.
Right, OK. Fern, how do you know Ken?
This is Ken, and he and I are part of the same Morris dancing troupe.
Right. Finally, David, what is your connection to Ken?
This is Ken, and Ken drives a steam engine and recently let me ride in the cab with him.
Well, I think we all know which is the favourite. We'll start with Richard. He said it was a Shakespearean soliloquy.
Yeah. It was a version of Hamlet's To Be or Not To Be.
Chuck up. Chuck up, chuck up. Yeah.
Yeah.
And was there rapping? Was there a bit of... Was it any?
Martin, you're really down with the kids.
That is the question.
Not that I can
is it the question?
No.
Did you keep with the original, or did you change the words?
No, the words were as is.
As is.
Yeah.
How did it go? Can you do a bit?
What sort of music was it? Was it lutes and, you know, Shakespearean styly, or was it something more contemporary? Yeah,
was it
reggae
like lutes and harps and ting?
It was garage and hip hop.
Is it? Is it though?
For real. For real, for real.
Well, there's certainly no doubting the hip-hop credentials of Lee's team.
And how did Ken convince you that that was a good idea?
He asked me.
Is that all it takes for you, Richard?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do you think I'm here? What was on the B-side? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day or whop it up thee straight away?
Okay, Fern, just remind us again.
This is Ken, and we are part of the same Morris dancing troupe.
Right, and how often do you do that?
In summer, it could be every weekend.
It could be, but is it?
How do you combine this with your TV commitments?
Well, obviously, if I'm working, I don't go and do it, because there's a troupe of 12 of us.
And where do you do it? Where do you Morris?
We Morris at the county shows.
Are you pretty good at Morris dancing? You know where this is leading, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah.
So, could we have a demonstration, Fern, at all?
I would feel silly.
Well, you're on the right show.
Yeah.
OK, right, David, remind us of yours again.
He drives a steam train and he gave me a ride in his cab.
Right, and how did this crop up?
It was...
you were doing that.
Yeah. It was at my brother's 30th birthday do, which was at the Didcot Railway Museum.
There is nothing you've said so far that we doubt. Right, and why did your brother choose that? Was it ironic?
I think there was elements of irony and elements of genuine enjoyment. Yeah. Very much like this show.